Hey everyone, my name is Sophie Barnett and I'm going to be your host for the Duke Lemur Center's brand new web series, Lemur Fever. In this web series, I'm going to be teaching you, the viewer, everything you want to know about lemurs. So, let's get started! Type of primate, just like you and me. They're actually the oldest primate, as they evolved long before monkeys, apes, and humans. They're also the most diverse primate in the world, with about 100 different existing species. They're located off the southeast coast of Africa on an island called Madagascar. Way back before humans were around, lemurs freely roamed the lush forests of Madagascar with low numbers of predators and a lot of different types of habitats. This combination allowed them to evolve into many different species with differing factors from one another. One of these differing factors is size. The mouse lemur, which is the smallest primate in the world, is about 9 centimeters tall, the size of the palm of my hand, all the way up to the now extinct subfossil lemur, also known as the giant lemur, which weighed 159 kilos, the size of a gorilla. Another differing factor is lemur sleeping schedules. For example, the red ruff lemur is
diurnal,
that they're awake during the day and that they sleep at night, just like you and me. Eye-eyes are nocturnal, which means that they sleep during the day and they're awake at night. And collared lemurs are cathemeral, which means that they don't really have any sort of set sleeping pattern. They actually change their sleeping pattern based on the season in Madagascar. There's two seasons in Madagascar. There's the wet season and then there's the dry season. During the wet season, collared lemurs are
diurnal,
just like you and me. And then during the dry season, they become nocturnal. But why lemurs? There are multiple reasons that we should devote time to saving lemurs. One of those many reasons is that they could potentially be the key to space travel. Fat-tailed dwarf lemurs are one of the only known primates to go through hibernation. By studying these lemurs during hibernation, we can potentially mimic the functions of their body onto that of a human, thus allowing astronauts to go into hibernation for a few weeks at a time, allowing even more distance to be traveled in space. Since lemurs are the oldest primates, can study their habits and traits and compare that to monkeys, apes, and humans to get a better understanding of evolution. I mean, they've been around for 50 million years. They must be doing something right. The thing is, if these lemurs die out in the wild, we'll never be able to unlock these potential scientific breakthroughs, not to mention it will be a devastating loss to the ecosystem. That's why it's crucial that we act now to help save these amazing creatures before it's too late. There are many different ways that you can help save the lemurs. Don't keep lemurs as pets. Although they are cute, they are not cuddly, and they're not domesticated like your dogs and cats. Baby lemurs are forcibly removed from their habitat in the wild to be sold into the pet trade. This causes severe psychological trauma that renders the lemur aggressive and unable to be reintroduced into the wild, zoo, or any other research center. Don't pay for selfie experiences with wild animals, because that also promotes the pet trade. By doing the aforementioned things, you can personally help save the lemurs. Everybody's efforts, no matter how big or how small, all contribute to a cleaner future. If you learned something new, like this video. If you want to keep learning new things, subscribe. Follow Lemur Fever DLC on Instagram and Twitter for updates. Email lemurfeverdlc@gmail.com video footage of you asking a question about lemurs, and you might be featured on a future episode. And before I end this episode, I want to give a special thanks to my intern manager, Sarah Clark. Sarah, without you, none of this would be happening. Anyways, thanks for watching Lemur Fever, and I'll see you next time.